time at Forth Valley College, you will be working towards gaining qualifications in your area of interest. However, as well as these qualifications, there is something vital, and this is core and essential skills.
Every employer is looking that you can perform to a certain standard, be able to write reports, letters, be able to understand text, journals, instructions, be able to work the software, be able to research for information, and be able to perform and understand budgets, take stock. All these come into core and essential skills class, and we work towards a standard that you're going to be employed.
The core and essential skills we are teaching you are required by employers. Up next are some employers who will emphasise on the importance of this.
When we are recruiting for a new candidate, regardless of where that is across the organisation, there are different forms that it can come in, electronically or hard copy. Hard copy can either be by way of a covering letter and a CV, or it can be via the company application form. In all instances, the application needs to be very clear and concise in terms of what the candidate is applying for. So in relation to emails, keep it professional. Generally, just proper use of the name with a, and it doesn't really matter what the email provider, service provider is, but a sensible or professional name. I would always encourage a candidate to think about the organisation that they are applying to and tailor their application and think about what the employer may be expecting or requiring. Then there is the way in which they conduct themselves during the course of the interview. Are they clear and articulate in terms of their speech? Can they actually string a sentence together and come up with a reasonably logical set of answers to the questions that are put to them? Have they done some research on the property to ask some valid questions at the end, either that's about the role or us as an organisation? We would expect all of our employees, regardless of role, to have at least basic rudimentary numeracy ability. Every single role that we have on property requires some element of working with numbers. So even if you are working as a kitchen porter, as part of the back of house support services team, there'll be some crockery and glassware and cutlery stock check that you'll be involved with, so you at least need to be able to count and add up or subtract. Equally, for anybody who is operationally based serving the customers, they'll be using some of the billing systems, so that they need to be able to work those appropriately and know that the numbers add up at the end. So punctuality is key. We have had a number of incidents where people have turned up late on a number of occasions. Invariably, we would deal with that informally to begin with, but if it's a repeat offence, then it gets escalated in terms of how seriously we review it. So people have left the organisation as a consequence of repeated lateness or poor timekeeping and attendance. What candidates really need to be conscious of is how their social media or online profile is presented and how accessible that is for a prospective employer or an existing employer.
We would expect a candidate to have done some preparation into the background of our business before they come to the interview. That would show an interest in the type of work we do on site. It would also show that they believe that their skill set could be in some way married to what we're looking for within our own company. During the interview process, we expect candidates to have put some effort into the presentation of how they will appear at the interview. First impressions can be very important for companies when they're interviewing individuals. Communication skills are very important for us in our business. Verbal communications, written communications and electronic communications. Verbal communications are very important because often you're the first person who will contact the public. Written communications, because often you have to send letters out on behalf of our business. And the electronic communications, because these communications are what we use primarily as a function within site, communicating between different functions. The numeracy skills that we use in this place of work are varied. In our finance group, basic numeracy skills for numbers is important. In manufacturing, numeracy skills for calculating weights and measures for raw materials and chemicals is significantly important to our business.
Come with a little bit of passion and pride and enthusiasm, a willingness to learn, and the world quite literally is your oyster.